are usually laced with festivity, but an early qualifying, Blaine Johnson met with ultimate tragedy just before the finish line. Pocket for 50 grand.
It was all about drag racing. I mean, that was what we did. That's, you know, besides working, it was all drag racing.
The hottest driver in Top Fuel racing this year, Blaine Johnson and his Travers Tool Company car, with the wheels up off the starting line, took away the top qualifying spot and recorded the quickest run in history. 4.592.
You know, we talked about wanting to race professionally at some point, and that really came to light when we sold our dairy in 1984. So we were both fresh out of college with our dairy science degrees and then sold the dairy, so we had to look for something to do. And, you know, our goal was to try and make a living out of drag racing. You know, I was the driver. He was too young to drive at the time. You know, I think I started when I was 18, 19, 20, right in there, and he was 4 years behind me. You know, I just kept telling him, hey, when you get old enough, you can drive. You know, then he got old enough, and I still wouldn't let him drive. But he just kept pressuring me. And eventually, I thought it was probably a good idea to put him in the car and let him drive and let me just be the crew chief.
And Blaine Johnson picks up the win with a 473, 299 miles an hour.
You know, the amazing thing about my brother was that not only was he was, you know, an exceptionally good driver, but he also knew everything about the car. You know, when we first started racing Top Fuel, you know, I had just started my cylinder head company, so he worked for me. There were days when, you know, he'd punch the clock and just work on the race car, assemble the race car and do all that. When my brother first started driving, you know, I knew before he even started driving that he'd be a good driver. He's just one of those kids that was, his focus was exceptional, you know, so you could put him in any situation and he was, you know, he could, if I had him running a CNC machine, he could block out everything there was and do programming on that, and there was nothing that could interrupt him. He just had really good focus, and then and driving, you know, nothing rattled him. You know, he got in the car and he had a job to do, and he took care of it, and nothing scared him, so he was really good at it. We, you know, I could tell him exactly what I thought. He could tell me exactly what he thought, and we'd never get angry at each other about that. You know, it's like our communication level is really good. And I'll tell you, the longer we worked together and raced together, sometimes we didn't even have to talk because we knew exactly what the other guy was doing all the time anyway. So we were really close, so our communication was great.
The fans got a thrill. Scott Coletta turned it over backwards. Blaine Johnson was able to avoid the spinning Coletta.
You know, it's obviously we knew what the dangers were. You know, and there was things that, you know, we did. We made sure that our car was safe. You know, we had all the best safety equipment. You know, we did everything we could to, you know, protect him, but it was nothing that we ever really talked about.
Sometimes, Blaine, these cars have a mind of their own.
Yeah, obviously, this one does. Went out there, smoked the tires, I was going to pedal it. Obviously, I could have beat him a little bit better than that, but it shut off for some reason, I don't know why.
When you go home with a world record, that's some consolation.
Yeah, a little bit. We wanted to win this thing, man. We needed a win bad.
There's one coming soon, I'm sure.
As well as we raced in 95 and didn't get a win until the last race, we knew that once we broke through that, you know, we were going to get some wins in 96. And as the season went, you know, along, you know, we got a points lead and we kind of built on the points lead. And, you know, we had our sights set on winning the championship. I mean, we were fired up. We were focused. We were ready to go.
Not only are you here, the entire Travers Tool team is here with Jim Head. It's where you need to be at the races.
Well, you know, this is what we love to do. This is what my brother loved to do. And, you know, he wouldn't want it any other way. You know, he'd be over here if he could still be here.
In 10 years of racing, almost, 20 years later, 25 years later, people hold your brother in such high esteem. What does that mean to you?